Those who create complex, real-time data sharing systems use data distribution service. The others are looking for alternatives. Why is that? Why? In this video, I'm going to share with you why you should consider data distribution service as a communication middleware for your system. Imagine a situation where you need to create a new industrial IoT system. However, creating such a distributed system is a challenge because there are many elements that need to communicate with each other and there are many things that can go wrong. You are likely to address the following concerns during the creation of the system. Because system elements such as devices or applications can enter or leave the system, so the structure of the system changed dynamically. The next problem. Distributed systems are constantly evolving throughout their life cycle. So we all know that changes are inevitable, but changes can lead to integration problems if you change interfaces. Unreliable network can result in network failures and loss of network packets, and how you will deal with this. Problem can cause device and application failures. So it's fine. You can detect these failures so you can quickly recover to the normal state of the system. With a lot of data, you can also encounter congestion issues, such as network packet congestion or congestion in applications that cannot process as many messages. Also, each part of a distributed system may have different network characteristics, and you may encounter different or variable throughput or latency in different part of your system, and how you will deal with this. And last but not least, you need to address security issues, of course, and many, many more. One thing, according to Eclipse Foundation survey, the top three concerns for IoT developers are security, connectivity, and deployment. The good news is that you can resolve these challenges by selecting appropriate communication protocol or data sharing technology between the system components, and that can make your life easier. However, there are many communication protocols and technologies, and each is suitable for a specific purpose because they were designed to solve specific requirements. Usually, their functionalities do not overlap, except that they allow data to be sent. But which one to choose? It's good to realize that IoT systems are often large and they will always combine different communication protocols and technologies. This is because different parts of the system require different approaches to interconnecting the various components of the system. You will need therefore consider what will be the most suitable application protocol or communication technology and for which part of the system. You have a lot to choose from. For example, application protocols like HTTP, gRPC, WebSockets, MQTT, IMQP, Xeno, ZeroMQ, CoAP, and from technologies you can choose from ActiveMQ, RabbitMQ, HiveMQ, DDS, Apache Kafka, OPCOA, to name the most familiar ones. But keep in mind that today, more than ever, everyone requires a system that is responsive, fault-tolerant, able to cope with changing workloads, and as well is maintainable and extensible. And such systems are referred to as reactive systems. So we are finally getting to DDS, because with DDS you can build a reactive system as well. Let's see what were the specific requirements behind the creation of DDS technology. Data distribution service was designed from ground up and architected for mission-critical systems based on the following requirements. So the technology should provide fast, efficient, real-time coordination between a system's computational elements, on one side, which are components written in software, and physical elements on the other side, which are components that interact with the physical world. The technology should be performant, so it can provide high throughput and very low latencies. It should be reliable and fault-tolerant, even on unreliable communication links. It should provide ability to scale the computational and physical elements to hundreds or thousands. It should also provide ability to evolve, upgrade, integrate, and deploy the system seamlessly. It should be secure, and it should be standard, so it will be interoperable between vendors and creators of the systems. That's what the DDS was built for. And as you are going to see, these requirements correlate with systems for the industrial Internet of Things and autonomous systems. Maybe you are thinking now, for what purposes is the DDS technology most commonly used? Am I creating a similar system? DDS technology originally came from a military environment, and the creators intended to achieve high reliability and scalability for their mission-critical systems. But since then, the technology has evolved according to the newly emerged requirements for modern systems, and has thus spread also to other areas. So, for example, in air traffic management systems, battle management systems, power management systems, transportation management systems, but also to autonomous driving, robotics, and into the hospitals. In all these areas, it provides connectivity between different parts of the systems, so between sensors, actuators, control systems, computational softwares, and user interfaces. So, that's all, and I hope you have got an idea what were the reasons for the creation of this technology, what type of systems can benefit from this technology the most, and overall, why you should consider it as a communication middleware for your system.